Hello students, welcome to the class on answer writing, and in this class I will be dealing with the answers of the questions that I have posted on 19th of October on brainiki.com. Now the first question was like, African continent holds lot of promises and potential, but for it to fructify, world needs to invest in human development commitment. Now, why had I posted this question on brainiki.com? The reason for posting this question was, in the editorial on African, India-African summit, the author to the lead editorial, he has put forward a very rosy picture about African continent, which actually is not the reality. Now if you look at the reality of the African continent, there is mass poverty, there is mass human deprivation, there is mass prevalence of social evils, social ills, there are civil wars, the states have failed in African continent, democracy has failed to entrench in African continent. Now if you really want to derive the economic benefits out of the market of African continent and out of the resources from African continent, you really need to invest in the human development over there, because until and unless there will be no human development, there will be no demand of the goods and the services. And if India, or for that matter any nation, wants to deal economically with the African continent, it will be more or less like economic colonization of that continent, and that will be something that this entire continent had faced during the 19th and the 20th century. We can't put this continent under the same situation again and same condition again. So in order to derive the benefits, we need to create mutual relation, synergetic relation, a relation of unison in which not only India is benefited, but also the African continent is benefited. And you can also mention about the policies of the various countries with respect to South Africa. Now how there has been a change, like from 50s till the 80s and 90s, this continent was neglected, and before 50s, from 18th, 19th and 20th century, this was exploited by the imperialistic and the colonistic forces. But 1950s, we had seen the democracy getting engendered over the entire world, in the entire world, and that has left this continent in isolation. But now this continent is moving out of isolation. If we really want to do something great with this continent, we really need to invest in the human development, and only then we should be looking to derive some economic benefit out of it. Now, you must answer this question like this, and in terms of development, you must focus on sanitation, you must focus on health, you must focus on education, you must focus on the condition of women, you must focus on the prejudices, stereotypes and superstitions prevalent in this part of the continent. Now nobody has, I think nobody has mentioned these things. Then next question is, analyze the role of United Nations with respect to the failure of its mandate to entrench peace in the world. Now this is a very important question. Now, in order to answer this question, you really need to know about the Article 6 and Article 7 of the UN Charter. Now, what does these articles say? So these articles, they have conferred asymmetrical power to the Security Council of United Nations. Now Article 6 of the United Nations Security Council says that negotiation should be followed, if there is a conflict, arbitration should be followed, and then the mediation should be followed if there is a conflict in the nations. So this is a kind of NAM ideology, negotiation, arbitration and mediation. And if this will not turn out to be the solution, in that case Article 7 says that the Security Council, permanent Security Council members, have the right to use the force to establish peace. But this entire security consulate has remained divided in P2 to P3. Like United States of America and England, they have remained on one side, and rest of the countries of the Permanent Security Council, they have remained mostly on the other side, China, Russia. Now, there has been a division, and it is because of this reason, United Nations has failed to act on any number of situations, be that the Vietnam crisis, be that the Korean crisis, be that the Iranian crisis, be that the Yemen crisis, be that the Syria crisis, be that the Yugoslavia crisis, be that the Rwanda crisis, be that the Sudan crisis. Now this institution of United Nations, it had acted more as a geopolitical and geostrategic device for the United States of America and England to get their interests fulfilled. So this was used as a conduit, this was used as a tool. So United Nations, as far as its role in keeping the peace is concerned, it has performed a partial role, though it has helped in the prevention of World War III. Now World War III had also not taken place because earlier the powers were very much asymmetrical. Now that asymmetrical has shifted towards the way of symmetrical. Now how this has shifted? Earlier we were having just few nuclear powers. There were just 5 nuclear powers. Now we have got various nuclear powers. Iran is also a nuclear power. Pakistan is also a nuclear power. Korea is also a nuclear power. Israel is also a nuclear power. India is also a nuclear power. Though some of them are not accepted by the NPT treaty and the nuclear supplier groups. Though we are not party to the agreements like Wassenaar agreement, Zanganar agreement and Australia group. But certainly this proliferation of the nuclear technology has certainly helped in balancing the peace in the world. So you were supposed to write all these things out in the answer. The next third is, how fall in the commodity prices is a big concern. Yeah. Now you need to understand the entire cycle of how economy works. Now if there will be fall in the prices, now suppose I want to buy a car, suppose I want to buy a BMW, but there is this speculation that the prices of the BMW will fall. So I will not be buying the BMW. If I will not be buying the BMW, the production of the company will be still there. And if the production will still be there, their entire lot of the BMW cars will be stranded, because like the way I am thinking, and number of other people will also be thinking the same way. They would also be waiting for the prices to fall. Like we all wait for the Diwali offers, we all wait for the winter offs or the summer offs to buy the clothes and apparel, the whatever you like to buy. And in this type of a situation, the company, that's the BMW, its lot will be stranded. If it will be stranded, it will not be able to earn the revenue. If it will not be able to earn the revenue, it will not be able to pay the debt to the banks. If it will not be able to pay the debt to the banks, the banks will fail. If the banks will fail, then the banks will not lend it further to the other sectors or the other people. Now, if the banks will not lend, the economy will stagnate, and we will see the specter of the deflation. This was, you were supposed to write, and you were supposed to mention about the oil prices, the natural gas prices, the prices of the iron and steel, the prices of the copper, zinc, magnesium, etc., etc., and how this commodity market is getting stagnated. Then the fourth question is, Indian policy stance towards Nepal justified and ethical? Whatever India is doing, it is actually opposite to the Panch Sheel in which India had always believed in. India has always believed in the NAM. India has always believed in the non-transgression. India has always believed in maintaining the territorial integrity of the other nations. India has always believed in the process of negotiation. India has always believed not in putting the economic imbroglio over some other country. India has always believed in respecting the rights of all the countries. India has always believed in what is constituted by nationalism. So this was what you were supposed to write, and because of that, the action that the India is taking, it is more or less unethical and it will send a very wrong message, not only to South Asia or the Asian countries, but to the entire world. Now, in a situation when India is aspiring to become a permanent member in the United Nations, such kinds of actions by India makes her less credible. So our credibility quotient is going down, and if we really want it to rise, we need to be more pragmatic, we need to be more altruistic, we need not to be more opportunistic like China. So you must be using all these terminologies if you want to score good marks. The people say that I use a lot of difficult words and I'm not intelligent, I don't know, I have the knowledge, so that's okay for them. So this was all for the day. You can share this video, you can comment on this video, and you can like this video too. And please participate in answer writing program. It will really enrich. We have started it just new. We are getting very less participation, and that's okay, but still we will keep on doing it for at least 1 year. We are just experimenting with the thing to increase our subscriber base. So that's the main aim, explicit aim. So bye bye, take care, have a nice day.